Chapter 36. The heads of the fathers' families of Gilead, son of Machir, son of Manasseh, one of the families of the sons of Joseph, approached Moses and the chiefs, heads of families in Israel, and addressed them. "Sir," they said, "the Lord commanded you to distribute the land by lot to the Israelites, and you were also commanded to give the patrimony of our brother Zelophehad to his daughters. Now if any of them shall be married to a husband from another Israelite tribe, her patrimony will be lost to the patrimony of her fathers, and be added to that of the tribe into which she is married, and so part of her allotted patrimony will be lost. Then, when the Jubilee year comes round in Israel, her patrimony would be added to the patrimony of a tribe into which she is married, and it would be permanently lost to the patrimony of her father's tribe." So Moses, instructed by the Lord, gave the Israelites this ruling: "The tribe of the sons of Joseph is right. This is the Lord's command for the daughters of Zelophehad. They may marry whom they please, but only within a family of their father's tribe. No patrimony in Israel shall pass from tribe to tribe, but every Israelite shall retain his father's patrimony. Any woman of an Israelite tribe who is an heiress may marry a man from any family in her father's tribe. Thus the Israelites shall retain each one the patrimony of his forefathers. No patrimony shall pass from one tribe to another, but every tribe in Israel shall retain its own patrimony." The daughters of Zelophehad acted in accordance with the Lord's command to Moses: Mahla, Tirzah, Hogla, Milcah, and Noah. The daughters of Zelophehad married sons of their father's brothers. They married within the families of the sons of Manasseh, son of Joseph, and their patrimony remained with the tribe of their father's family. These are the commandments and the decrees which the Lord issued to the Israelites through Moses in the lowlands of Moab by the Jordan near Jericho.